Let's start with the easy one first, the exit button. We already know how to code the exit button. You don't need to comment this, but it is good to comment every procedure. Let's not forget that we want to put a comment block at the top of all of our projects. Again, save your project periodically and do the save all. Don't do save as. Okay? Make sure you're saving all. Once you've saved your project the first time, save all periodically after making changes. Remember, what we're going to ask the user to do is to input three values, then click the calculate button. When the user clicks the calculate button, these three values will be captured, stored in a variable. We're going to discuss that they have to be converted. And then the volume will be displayed in this label. So all of our work pretty much is going to be done in the calculate button, the calculate button's click event. The first thing we want to do in this event is define some variables. Variables are named memory locations that hold data while the computer program is running. Remember, we want to try to add comments within our event procedures. And we're going to define four variables. They're all integers. One for length. Use a naming convention for your variables. This is a recommendation, not an absolute requirement. But use a naming convention on your variables that is similar to the naming conventions we use for other objects. The name of your variables should be, doesn't have to be, the purpose of the variable and the class of the variable. In this case, the variables are going to be integers, so I'm going to call it length int. When I read in the code this name, I know it's a variable and it holds integer data. Now, notice the little green squiggly line. If we hold the mouse pointer over it, it simply tells us it is unused. Well, that's because we haven't finished writing our program. I also want to remind you that if you have multiple variables of the same data type, in this case we do, you can put them all on one line with one dim statement. Make sure they're comma separated. Now, that is valid, what I just did here. And I won't take any points off from you if that's what you do. But I'll tell you, I prefer to see it one variable per line. To me, it's just easier to read and debug. Now that we've got our variables defined, the next step is to capture the data from the text box text properties and store them into these variables. However, remember that any data in the text property of an object is string or character data. It's called string data. But in order for us to do our mathematical calculations, we've got to have some sort of number data type. So we created the length, width, and height integers as the variables as integers so that they'll hold integer values. So what we have to do is convert the string data from the text boxes to integer data and store them into the variables. So the next block of code we're going to do is to convert the string data from the text boxes and store the converted data in the variables. We're going to do this using the triparse method. The triparse method is a method, the integer class. So our syntax is type integer dot triparse. And the triparse method requires two arguments. Notice the tooltip that pops up here. It tells us kind of how to use the triparse method. The two arguments are, where is the data coming from that needs to be converted? And then the second argument is, where are we going to store the converted data? We're getting the data from the length text box dot text. That's where we're getting the data from. The second argument is, where are we going to store the converted data? We're going to store it in the length int variable. We're going to do the same thing for width and height. Now, a quick cheat is we can just copy and paste it twice, but make sure you change the necessary data. Now, notice that all the green squiggly lines have gone away except for the volume variable, because we haven't used the volume variable yet. So the next thing we're going to do is calculate volume and display it. We're going to use an assignment statement. We're going to assign to the volume int variable whatever is in length int times width int times height. So whatever value is in the length integer variable is multiplied by the width integer variable and multiplied by the height integer variable. So that's length times width times height equals volume. We multiply these three pieces of data and store them in this variable. Then we use another assignment statement to store what's in this variable to our label.text property. However, remember, this is integer data. The text property of the label is string data. We've got to do another conversion. We're going to do a different type of conversion here. We're going to use the assignment statement, and we're going to assign to volume label.text property. We're going to use the convert class in the toString method. So we type in convert.toString, and the toString method requires one argument. It is the data that needs to be converted, which is volume int. So whatever data is in volume int, which is an integer, gets converted to string and then assigned to the text property of the volume label. Let's save and test our program. If I enter 5 for the length, 4 for the width, and 3 for the height, and click calculate, I get 60 displayed. 5 times 4 is 20, times 3 is 60, it's displayed. Now remember, I could use the enter key to click the calculate button, or the escape key to click the exit button. I'm going to use the escape key now. Let's see if that works, and it did. Okay. Now keep in mind that there are other ways to convert. We've seen a couple of ways here. Now you can't use every method to convert from integer to string or from string to integer. Make sure you review those different things in the chapters as we progress through the class. We also talked about ways of preventing a user from entering anything but digits or the decimal point if you choose to use decimal data types and the backspace key in a text box. That is something covered in a later chapter, and if you're curious, you can always give me an email and I'll try to help you with that. Thank you.